Hello everyone, another class, another session, and this time we are going to study report writing. Okay, so as it suggests, let me tell you what it means. Report writing is an important writing skill which covers a number of areas like science, technology, current affairs, reviews, etc. So, as the title suggests, report writing is it refers to your writing skill. Okay, so these are the areas that it covers: any report or any information related to science and technology, related to current affairs or reviews. So that is where your report writing skill comes into use. I would like to explain this in a better manner by moving on to the next slide. Let's see what it is about. Characteristics of a report. Okay, they are always factual. So report writing, when we talk about, the reports are always based on facts. Okay, then the information is verified, and whenever you write a report, you write it on the basis of an information which is verified. It cannot be something which you are not sure of. It is based on facts and verified at the same time. So the next is, they are aimed at people with specific interests in that area. Now, report writing is, or writing of reports is for those people who are interested in that specific area. For example, if you write a report on science, then it is going to be read by the people who are interested in such information related to science or technology or current affairs. So keeping those things in mind. The passive form of the verb is generally used. And one very important thing, when you write reports, you have to keep in mind that you use the passive form of writing. You have already had a class on active and passive voice, and that is there in your syllabus as well. So you should be knowing what passive voice is when we talk about. Okay, so when you write a report, it has to be in the passive form of the verb. These were the characteristics of report. Now, reading and interpreting graphs. Here, when we talk about report writing, we are basically talking about these graphs. Okay, now let us see. Line graphs, bar graphs, and pie charts. So report writing in your syllabus is based on the statistical inference, okay, of a given data. Now that can be in the form of a line graph, right? That can be in the form of a bar graph. The data can be given to you in the form of a bar graph. That is also known as a histogram. So that is one thing. Or the third type can be these pie charts. Okay, so when a data is shared or given to you in this manner, in the form of either a line graph or a bar graph or a pie chart, then you have to understand what it says and then write a report. Okay, on that. All right, reading and interpreting is what it said. Interpretation. It involves reading, understanding, and expressing the data represented in a verbal medium in a paragraph of about 120 to 150 words. Now, this is something very important that you should understand, that interpretation of the data involves, the very first thing is you should read, you should take note of the important things. What does that graph represent? What is it talking about? You have to take a note of that. You have to understand what is being represented with the help of that particular graph or a chart. And then expressing the data represented in a verbal medium. That was A graph or a chart is a diagrammatic representation. Okay, so you have to convert it into words, in a verbal medium. You have to represent it. So that has to be converted into words. Report has to be written in words. And a very important thing that you need to keep in mind is that you have to write it in a paragraph of 120 to 150 words. Okay, there is a word limit. So majority of the times you are supposed to write a report in 120 to 150 words. You should always stick to the word limit and never exceed it. All right, you should understand that. So I think I am clear here. I repeat, when you are given a line graph, a bar graph, or a pie chart, any of these, you should first take a note of it, read it, find out the important things that it is trying to highlight, then understanding, and then finally expressing it in words. And the word limit is 120 to 150 words. Okay? Now, there are these 7 C's of report writing, some important points that you should remember when you write a report. So these are the ones you should remember, these 7 C's. The first is concrete. So as it was told to you initially, that a report is always factual, okay, and verified. So it has to include all the facts and figures. Whatever that graph or chart represents, it is based on facts, and you have to include that in your report. When you write the report, you have to include the facts and figures as it is. Next C is complete. All the points must be covered. Whatever is presented in the data or in the graph or in the chart, you have to cover all the points clearly. Okay. Now, the third is concise. It has to be to the point, right? You should not be writing excessively. You should not be beating about the bush. Your writing should be crisp as needed, okay? Whatever information is mentioned, you have to write that in your sentence and in your report. And there shouldn't be repetition. So, when I say concise, you have to avoid repetition and monotony. Monotony is getting tired of something, creating a tiresome sort of an environment. So that is monotony. How do you avoid monotony? When you avoid repetition, you avoid monotony. So the report has to be concise. Correct. Avoid spelling and grammatical errors. Now, very important point here, one of the 7 C's is that it has to be correct. Whenever you are writing a report, whenever you are writing something, you have to be very careful of the spellings that you use and the grammar, because you can never overlook these facts. So when you are writing the report, make sure that you avoid any errors related to spelling and grammar. So it should be correct. Clear. The report must be unambiguous. Now, it should be clear, meaning to say there should be just one idea and it shouldn't be confusing for the people, right, to understand whatever you want to say through your report. So the interpretation should be clear, okay, and not confusing. That is what unambiguous means. Coherent. So one of the 7 C's is coherent, that the report should have cohesive devices in it. Cohesive devices are these linkers, okay? When we talk about linkers, when we link a sentence to another by the use of linkers, you have been taught linkers as well in quite detail, sir has already told you. So when you write a report, you have to keep in mind that the report is coherent. One idea is clearly linked with the other idea. Okay? So for that, you have to use linkers. That is why any report should be, any piece of writing should be coherent. It shouldn't be one sentence speaks about something and the other sentence is completely different from the previous one. It is a wrong way of writing. So the ideas should be linked to each other, connected to each other in a proper manner, and for that you need to use the cohesive devices. And when I say cohesive devices, I mean linkers. Okay, so be careful about this point, that the report should be coherent. And the last but not the least, credible. Okay, it should be convincing. Credible means the report that you write, it should be convincing. And how do you make it convincing? With by the use of impressive language. Okay, impressive language is the use of proper words, appropriate vocabulary. Okay, if you need to use idioms, if you need to use some phrases, you need to use them so as to make the report convincing, credible at the same time. So the language should be impressive. So these are the 7 C's of report writing: concrete, complete, concise, correct, clear, coherent, and credible. If you keep in mind all these 7 points, you would be sorted completely. There won't be any problem in writing the report. Okay? All right. Now, let's move ahead. There's a specimen here. The question goes like this. A survey was conducted on software job locations in India, and the results are shown in the following pie chart. Using the data, write a report in about 120 words. So this is the data in front of you. This is a pie chart which shows the software job locations in India. Okay. Now there are these places mentioned: Bengaluru, Delhi, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Chennai, Hyderabad, and the percentage has also been mentioned there. So you are to read the report properly. You have to take note of the important things that the report speaks about here, that the data speaks about here, okay, the pie chart, and then understand and finally move on to turning it or changing it into words, okay, conversion into words. So let us see what the specimen is about when it is in a report form. Okay, I'll just read it out. The provided pie chart represents a detailed information about a study conducted on software job locations in India. To begin with, Bengaluru has the highest job locations with a staggering 30%, as it is widely regarded as the Silicon Valley of India, also the center of India's high-tech industry. Moving forward, Hyderabad stands second with 19%, as it is the high-tech. High-tech is Hyderabad Information Technology and Engineering Consultancy. It is a high-tech city. As far as Delhi is concerned, it is positioned third with 17%, as it provides diverse job avenues. Ahmedabad is fourth in the list with 12%. Finally, Mumbai and Chennai share the last position with a mere 11%. The IT industry is a boon to the country's economy. However, for the emergence of other cities to be IT hubs, the government has to revise its policies, provide sufficient area for the development of good infrastructure, as well as enhance the skilled workforce. So that is just a specimen of how a report can be written based on a given pie chart. It was a pie chart here. So that one thing I would like to tell, please adhere to the word limit. Only a sentence is enough as an introductory sentence. Okay, one introductory sentence as to what is that thing about and what are you going to write. Then immediately come to the point. Okay, what you want to express. as you have been told not to leave out on anything, so you have to choose which point needs emphasis, okay, needs to be emphasized, and which can just be touched. So that is your discretion, that is your decision, that which point or which aspect of the line graph or the bar graph or the pie chart you want to emphasize on, and which thing you just need to touch and get going, not write a lot about. That is a balance that you have to make, you have to decide. Another thing, when you have written the report, you must come to a concluding sentence as well as to what you think about, what is your interpretation seeing the data there. Okay, that is something which is important, because as the topic suggests, report writing, you are actually writing a report. It is not just the statistical inference, not just writing the data, converting it into words, it is also coming to a conclusion as to why do you think is it such, is it so. Okay, so that is something that you need to keep in mind. This question carries 5 marks in the exam, though it is a question which has a choice. Okay, it is question number 33, and there's a choice in it. You you can choose between speech writing and report writing. So that's up to you. Though it's a choice question, but you have to decide which you find the best, and you can do judgment with the best one. Okay, do it in the best possible manner, whichever question you can attempt. So report is to be written in this manner, and I hope I have made it clear to you. Any questions, you can anytime come back and just open the book. There are some questions there, you can try going through them and try writing a report of those on those questions. Okay, that will give you a better idea of it. All right, so that's about it today. Hope you have understood, and have a good day. Take care.